Hello everyone, welcome to my video as a part of activity of week 2 for the International FDP on Environment and Sustainability organized under the banner of UNESCO. Okay. I am Dr. Tejaswini Desai from KIT's College of Engineering, Kolhapur. About the first week, it was regarding environmental awareness. Lot many case studies related to almost all sectors of engineering, electronics, chemical, civil, mechanical, software. They were provided like food packaging industry, virtualization computing, chromatography, LED, etc. Through all these case studies. And there were expert lectures like Green IT, ICT for Sustainability. We learned lot many things. To mention few, I would say we learned the guidelines of EIA, Environmental Impact Assessment, for the approval of any project. What are the parameters for that? What is carbon footprint and how to calculate carbon footprint? And what is the effective way to use the domestic appliances? What is energy audit? That also we learned. Importance of biodiversity was also there. And one important thing I would like to say that for sustainable development, we have to switch from linear economy to circular economy. So these R's, reuse, recycle, these R's are important. And the waste produced in one process can be the raw material for the other process. Okay. So this is about week 1, and now we switch over to week 2. Now in week 1, also, we produced one video. So this is the video for my week 1. This is the URL. And in week 1, the topic of my video was non-conventional energy sources and what is the application of nanomaterial for environmental control. Okay. In this video, I will talk about solar cell. It works on the principle of photovoltaic effect, that is, light energy is converted into electric energy. So though the effect was discovered in 1839, the first application was in satellite technology in 1960, and actual use of solar panel. So solar panel, these are number of solar cells interconnected in horizontal and vertical rows, and the application of solar panel came into existence in 80s decade. And in the beginning of 21st century, the application or the use of solar panels has been increasing. So this is the photovoltaic effect. So solar cell, it is the p-n junction. So you can see this is the junction. So when light is incident on a semiconductor, then we know electron hole pair is generated. So at the junction potential is there, and due to this junction potential, the charge carriers are separated and then we get electricity. So the light energy is converted into electric energy. What is the efficiency of conversion? So theoretically, conversion efficiency for solar cell is only 33%. And again, it depends on many factors like what is the average annual sunshine, surrounding area, type of installation and location, because incident radiation is not same everywhere. It depends or it changes from place to place. So what are different types of photovoltaic cells? So first it is the silicon. 95% of photovoltaic panels are made up of silicon. Here we can either use polycrystalline silicon solar cell, or we can use single crystal. If we use single crystal, we get better efficiency. Or we may use thin film photovoltaic cell. Here we use the thin films of cadmium telluride or copper, indium, gallium selenide, or even we can try for CdSe. We can use any method like chemical vapor deposition method for the deposition of thin films. Or if you are using conducting substrate, we may use electrochemical method. We can also go for organic solar cells. Okay, here we can think for polymers. But here, thin film efficiency we get better. They are cheap also as compared to silicon. But the problem is cadmium can be toxic and it may give rise to pollution. So efficiency can be increased using solar concentrated, because we know solar energy, whatever we receive, the total energy we receive is very huge, but it is very dilute, and therefore we require solar concentrated. Avoid shaded area, keeping panel clean and controlling the temperature. What are the advantages of solar cells? It reduces the energy cost for the generation of electricity. It reduces the cost because sun will not be asking us the bill, electricity bill. Only the cost will be installation of PV panel. Environmentally friendly, because carbon emission will be less. Because I don't say no carbon emission, because now we have learned that when we study environmental aspect and impact, we have to study the throughout life cycle of the product. So electricity generation by the PV panel is environmentally friendly, but actual when you develop or when you design the PV panel, it requires energy. So I cannot say that it is totally free of carbon emission, but it reduces. Its durability is more, 25 to 30 years, but again problem, durability is more, that is the advantage, but it cannot be recycled. And maximize grid security, because there is no transmission loss. Now we know transmission loss is much more in case of electricity or any generation. When we design the PV panel, of course, it has to meet the standards defined by BIS, Bureau of Indian Standards. So this is the list of some products and some standards. So what is the future scope for PV panel? Again, I will take the example of nanomaterials. We can think of carbon nanotube, especially armchair configuration, because it is semiconducting in nature. And if it is used in solar cell, it has the absorption characteristics for ultraviolet, visible and infrared, and therefore we get better efficiency. One more promising future we can consider by developing the PEN and coating that generates electricity. Here we consider carbon fullerene, that is buckyball C60. If this buckyball is dissolved in ink and it is printed onto plastic film, and these films can be applied to building facades, or it can be encapsulated in glass window through lamination. So these films are active in visible as well as ultraviolet region, and they are flexible and they can be customized. And one more advantage it has, it is 20 times lighter than our office paper. Okay, these are my references. Thank you, friends. Thank you very much.